Good morning. It's me, Mikey Pipes. And this is Multiple Bundles of Flex R8. We have some ductwork plenum here. Here, Chris and I, Air Force None, just assembled the supply plenum trunk.
You just assassinated that hanger.
I did?
I think so.
Well, there's so much crap in this basement. Like, don't they know we're coming in here to put their air conditioning back together that got devastated during a flood? All right? See that? The air handler used to sit there on the floor. And there's the flex going up to return in the wall. But don't they know that I'm coming here to restore their air conditioning? Don't they know it's going to be hot and humid this weekend? You'd think they would show some courtesy and respect for me, Mikey Pipes. What the front door? While we're waiting for the other Mike, Daniel, and Peter to show up, we're going to install this Bosch IDS 2.0 3-ton air handler. The condensing unit is outside. If you remember, we did this. This is the Bosch Green Therm 9900. It's got a nice little crystal display right there. Thing is epic. Look at that beautiful. Look at this beautiful boiler we installed too. You know, you got the bolt risers coming up top of the boiler tied in. It's really tits. The only thing we didn't do here is do a drop header. But nonetheless, as we watch Chris, Air Force None, vape. You're a vapor. Don't you know? That's metal in your lungs. All right, I think I just broke a nail, but it'll be all right. We got to put one more piece on here.
That's gonna cry.
I know. One more piece here. We're going to put the end cap in. We're going to put this in position here. We're going to take some markings because we're going to make our cuts on the top because we're going to go right there along that steam main, that uninsulated steam main. You see that, ladies and gentlemen? I know. Why don't people insulate their pipes? Well, all I have to say is let's go Bosch. All right, 10:50 in the morning, and I got to admit I made a mistake. All right. That Mikey Pipes messed up, and even the grill is the wrong size. We may have to make some modifications to this, and we'll get this to work, and then we'll, I hate to do it, but we'll just put a little bit of silicone there, maybe just a little bit. I gotta trim that down a little bit too. All right, let me show you what we got done downstairs because return is connected. All right, we got Dr. Brown's. We found Diet Dr. Brown's Black Cherry Soda, Pesach Soda. It was in a bag here. Took the liberty of stealing their sodas. Chris likes it too. All right, we have Daniel and the other Mike running some flex. Peter's sitting there with his thumb up his butt. Chris is holding up the boiler, and I'm about to have a union smoke break. Anyway, here's our base. Our filter is going to go in that filter rack right there. Here's our return. This is the box that the air handler is resting on. It comes up and it goes up there. This plenum is going to rest on that right there, and it goes all the way across. I already made an opening right there for it. And once we know where all our ducts are going to line up, our ducts are going to line up. I crack myself up. We're gonna mark each bay where our takeoffs are gonna go on top of this. And then we're gonna take some slips or drives, suspend this from the ceiling. We already got our line set, ran to the location. 3/8 is over there. Condenser's outside hooked up. Maybe have an earlier day today too.
It's a Friday.
It's a Friday. All right. I want to show you how tits this looks. Just outside of having my union smoke break. I got the whole fleet of Mercedes Sprinters here. I love them. Perfect amount too, no less. I could use one more, maybe like the Metris. That would be nice. All right, let me show you the outdoor unit. There it is, the Bosch IDS 2.0. 3-ton heat pump condenser on the high-rise pad. Looks so beautiful. What's gonna be looking even more tits is when we take this one out and that horrible, disgusting line set. Look at that. No care in the world when they put this in. Absolutely disgusting. Look at this. Look at this. But we're gonna take out this unit in the next couple weeks. Already got the equipment in stock. And then we're gonna have two beautiful Bosch IDS 2.0 condensers here. It's gonna be
sorry tits. I haven't gotten back to you. This is just highlights of today's install, which we started. Wow, this actual install started in around Christmas time of 2021 when the husband accidentally left the manual fill valve open for the steam boiler and flooded out his house.
But let me show you what we got so far. This supply plenum is about, I would say around 24 feet long. All right, and originally we had some duckboard here and we had the furnace sitting on the ground, right, next to that piece of duckboard, connected to that. And we ripped out all the ducts because they're all filled with water. And we're gonna bring these up and tighten everything up and make everything look nice and pretty and tits. But we got 11 takeoffs. Do you have a hole for that drilled already?
I gotta figure out where I'm gonna put it,
because
it's the one that's directly above the duct.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so you know what we'll do? We could rip that duct tape off there. I think we have a transition piece to go from oval to round. We'll come across here, all this. Let's look at the Bosch. There it is. I put it on some blocks. So in case the basement ever gets flooded, we're not gonna destroy that return plenum box it's sitting on. Looking very, very nice. Yeah, look at this. Very, very nice. You don't see that very often with multi-pipe and pipe boxes. I don't like doing stuff like this. Too much work. A nice 5-speed blower motor. Got all my Wagos ready for some low voltage wiring connection. Daniel is working on the line set. See, all the way there. He's using the Stay-Brite 8 to make some connections. How are we looking, Daniel? Almost 2:30.
Warm.
It's warm?
Yeah.
Did you put in force mode?
No.
Why not?
Did you want me to?
Don't we have to put in force mode to charge it up and like test everything?
You have to put it in force mode to read sub-cooling.
Okay. Makes sense. You know, you're a little crooked there, by the way.
You can find it straight.
Okay.
Which way am I?
You can't tell? Yeah. So, man, this thing is horrible. Look at that ugly ream compared to the Bosch, the sick and beautiful Bosch. This thing is amazing, night and day difference. And because there's a $2,000 control board in there, right? We're using the Rector Seal Surge Protector. I'm just gonna make sure this is nice and parallel with the house. Very nice. And look how quiet it is. Hear that? That's right, you don't hear it because it's that quiet. Yeah, the Fujitsu. Poor Fujitsu. That beautiful. How do you think you did today, Daniel? We got a lot accomplished today. We do. You know, yesterday I got home and my neighbor across the street has home serve there, and there's 3 trucks and there's a whole shitload of duct work in front of the house. You know, you can tell they're doing the air conditioning system, right? So I asked my wife, you know, Mrs. Pipe, what time did they get there? I was like, well, they got there right after you left for work this morning. And I think I left that like yesterday. I got there like left at 6:50, I think. Because I got to the shop and then you got right behind me. You know what time they left yesterday?
6:00.
Oh, try again.
8.
Close to it.
9.
The sun was almost down. Now, granted, they did have a delay because it poured. Remember yesterday we had that crazy rain?
You said it was ductwork. It was raining in the house.
They did not leave until like almost 9:00. 9:00. And not to mention, the front yard
looked like Kiev. Too soon? No. Maybe Beirut. Afghanistan. Like, how do you do that? So I actually took my dog for a walk, right? And I actually made a comment. I was like, hey, guys, I can't even walk on the sidewalk because you have all this garbage in it. Like, oh, we're sorry. Come on. You're going to be a professional. But it took them all day. We installed a 25-foot plenum. We ran 11 takeoffs. All new flex. We installed the return. Sat it on a base. Installed the line set. Put a surge protector on it. And guess what? The system is running and it is 2:30. Same day. Now granted, we took everything out already though.
Damn, you got screwed out of overtime.
Yeah. He likes going home early. What the hell is that noise?
Peter. The units.
Oh, I got him!
You have chopsticks?
I was gonna try to trick you.
Oh.
Making the noise the whole time.
When are you going back into the Air Force?
Till they
I can't wait.
Till they find enough money from Joe Biden.
F Joe Biden! Yeah. No, let's go Brandon. I don't want alien. Let me stop. Let me not alienate half of my viewers.
Half? That's a lot.
That is a lot. But they're used to it already.
Your viewers are retarded.
Nice.
Makes sense by they're watching you.
I hear you. Look at this nice, beautiful machine. So we have, this is a 60 or 80 speed inverter. I think it's
80 on, it's 80 on the compressor, it's 10 on the fan.
Okay, so it's 80 speed inverter compressor, 10 speed condenser fan motor, 5 speed blower motor, X13 blower motor.
But each unit does a different, like the 3 ton only goes up to 71 speeds in the compressor.
Correct. Oh, it's ramping up.
Yeah.
It's ramping up. Look how beautiful this machine is, guys.
The one yesterday, she called me and said, the bot, my son just called because she wasn't home yet.
Yeah.
And said, there's no air coming out of the vents and the house is hot. And I was like, I saw him messing with the thermostat. Just make sure it's on the right setting.
Make sure it's on the right thermostat, too.
They know the thermostat. And okay. She was like, okay, so... She called me on accident again an hour later, and he said he fixed the thermostat, and the house was like ice cold.
Icebox.
Yeah.
Now this is going to be the third system that we're also using primarily as a heat pump. Right? This is technically not an oil to heat pump conversion because they have gas and it's a steam boiler, and I happen to love steam. There's nothing like steam. As long as it's no one F's with it, the piping and the radiators, and does things that they shouldn't be doing, it's a beautiful, beautiful system. And those radiators, those cast iron radiators, they stay hot forever. But they're going to use this as the primary source of heat for the first floor because this system controls the first floor. This one here does the second floor with this stupid, retarded line set, by the way. And I'm sorry if I use retarded. I mean like idiotic, right? Trying to be politically correct here, right? And then the Fujitsu ductless is for the third floor. Now, someone made a comment yesterday. They live in New England, and they made a comment on having, why isn't this a side discharge, right? When it snows, his point of view was, when there's snow falling on top of this unit and the condenser fan blades are off, you're going to get snow accumulation on there. It's not going to want to turn. Yeah, I don't really know. If you're using this for heat, chances are the fan's running all the time anyway.
When do we ever get enough snow to climb all the way out?
No, I say dropping on top of it. Now, yes, granted, like the coils will freeze up. And that's why it has the automatic defrost mode. And as long as everything's wired correct, when it's in defrost mode, the indoor blower is not gonna blow. We learned that the other day at Platsky. Right?
Yeah.
As long as everything's wired correctly. So I don't see snow falling on top of this condenser fan motor, the blades themselves being an issue. I don't. And if anything, I think maybe the defrost mode would help melt it off, if there was. Because the coil, the condensing coil, which then acts as the evaporator coil, right? Because that's the opposite of heat pump, right? I think I'm right. Because air conditioning, this is the condensing coil. And for heat pump mode, this would be the evaporator coil. Because you're extracting the heat from outside the house in the winter and pushing it inside.
They still just call
it. I know, they still call it a condensing coil. What do you say, ladies and gentlemen? In heat pump mode, is this still called the condensing coil, or you want to call it the evaporator coil? And well, not, I guess technically it is always a condensing coil, and that's the evaporator, but the roles are reversed. It acts as an evaporator coil. The condensing coil acts as an evaporator coil. You learn something new every day. What an end of an amazing week. Short week, nonetheless. Tuesday. Hi, doggies. Stoli. GG. Oh, well. Tuesday, we took out that Phoenix solar system that had the built-in water heater, the tank. We put in the Burnham Alpine 210 with the Bedaris SU54 indirect water heater. Then, I think Tuesday we ran a bunch of service calls. No, sorry, Wednesday we ran a bunch of service calls. I gotta open up the pool cover. Yesterday, we installed the first Bosch IDS 2.0 system that Daniel himself actually sold and got himself a big fat paycheck for that. No joke. And today we completed the installation of that Bosch IDS 2.0 at a customer's home that we actually replaced the steam boiler on and put in a Bosch Green Therm 9900 tankless water heater. I feel so blessed and privileged to have an amazing team. Pipe Doctor, you know, we got Daniel, we got Peter, we got the other Mike, we got Air Force None, and we got me, Mikey Pipes. And I just feel so blessed to have all of them, and I want to give each and every single one of them a huge shout out. Thank you so much for putting up my BS, but I hope we all learn from one another every single day. All right, guys, time to reap the rewards of hard work. The water is 80 degrees, and it's time to go for a swim. It's time to go for a swim. All right, ladies and gentlemen, catch you on the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.